welcome to episode number 32 of WITM. And this is going to be a big episode because it is time for the final Monday Night Raw before our first Road to WrestleMania pay-per-view, Royal Rumble, where there will be a 30-man Royal Rumble match featuring 10 of the best superstars from Raw, SmackDown, and 205 Live, 10 representing each brand. But in the main event of Royal Rumble will be, thanks to Kevin Owens winning against in the triple threat champion versus champion versus champion match at Tribute to the Troops, Raw will main event Royal Rumble as well as three other major pay-per-views. And so, Kevin Owens will defend his Universal Championship, but who will his opponent be? This main event match here between Gerald, Randy Orton, Bobby Roode, and Brock Lesnar, four of the top five contenders to Universal Championship, could very well answer that question. But before we get into that, Vince McMahon and the Cruiserweight Champion, WITM's Andrew, are in the ring. A few episodes ago, Vince McMahon, knowing that Andrew's contract with 205 Live is about to expire, offered Andrew an opportunity to jump to Raw's main roster, not wrestling in Cruiserweight matches on Raw, wrestling the main roster on Raw, and returning to the main event scene on Monday Night Raw, where Andrew previously has been and won two Universal Championships during that time period. Will Andrew jump to Monday Night Raw, or will he stay loyal to the Cruiserweight division but put his career at risk in doing so? Let's join the chairman of the board, Vincent Kennedy McMahon, and WITM's Andrew in ring and hear what Andrew's decision will be. Andrew, I am very happy about your interest in signing for the flagship show, Monday Night Raw, and amassing even more fans and fortune. Now, you'll find all the documents are in place. You should just go ahead and sign on that X mark right there. And Andrew, one more thing. Don't have any second thoughts about signing this contract.
Sleeves, he ain't just putting on the Ritz. He's got thunder in his footsteps and lightning in his fists. And the Lord wasn't joking when he kicked him out of Eden. It wasn't for no reason that he shed his blood. His return is very close, so you better be believing. Our God.
Listen to me. You belong on 205 Live. The Cruiserweights there look up to you. You might not think they do, but they do. I've seen it, and I've heard it. You can't stand there and tell me that you're willing to give up on 205 Live when you willingly vacated the Universal Championship twice in order to get there. Andrew, you've done a lot for the Cruiserweight division, as well as the up-and-coming talent in NXT. So Andrew, please, don't be a sellout. And just a quick note here, the things that Andrew are about to say does not reflect how he feels about the real-life Gerald. This is just a storyline and the Andrew character speaking to the Gerald character. Look at you, Mr. Laughing Evangelist. The only funny thing I see here in this ring is you. Listen, old man. You've done great things at your age, but you are no Ric Flair. You don't have much longer of a career, and you're not even close to my caliber of wrestling. I figured that you wouldn't listen to me, so I arranged for someone else to try to talk some sense into you.
Behold the King, the King of Kings. On your knees, dog.
Hold everything. Triple H, this isn't your decision. Shut up, Andrew, if you know what is good for you, and just listen to me. do you really think, Andrew, that Vince really cares about your wrestling career? The answer is no. He only cares about ratings. Andrew, you are a hit on 205 Live, and the fans love you and the amazing things you've done. So Vince wants to cash in on that, so he can sign you to Raw and increase its ratings. But Andrew, once you sign that contract, Vince will begin to use you and abuse you. Which brings me to my second point. Andrew, Vince knows you are a threat at the Royal Rumble, and even potentially WrestleMania for 205 Live. And if he signs you, then the chances of a cruiserweight winning the Royal Rumble greatly diminishes without you. Andrew, Vince doesn't care about you. He just wants to sign the biggest threat 205 Live has, so he has a better chance of ending the cruiserweight division. So Andrew, don't be selfish and get a big ego. Think about what will happen to the rest of the cruiserweights if 205 Live is gone. Why do you think Vince told you not to have second thoughts about signing with Raw? He just wants to get rid of the biggest threat that 205 Live has to offer. As Andrew flips over the table, taking out Vince McMahon in the process, he shouts to Vince McMahon, "I will see your talent at WrestleMania." And so it looks like Andrew's decision has been made. He will put his career at risk and be part of the Cruiserweight division going forward. How much longer the Cruiserweight division will exist remains to be seen. A lot of it rides on the Royal Rumble, where 10 Cruiserweights representing 205 Live will compete against 10 members of Raw and 10 members of SmackDown, the winner earning their brand the main event of WrestleMania, and of course themselves a title opportunity in the main event of WrestleMania. And I want to give a shout out to Andrew, the real life Andrew. He is the vice president of WITM, and it was Andrew himself who came up with that storyline. So shout out to him. He does a ton to help out with WITM and has lots of great ideas. He's come up with some of the biggest storylines that we've used in WITM, so big shout out to Andrew. And I don't think this is going to load, so I will have to head off screen, reboot the game, and I will be back in a moment. Alright, we are back, and it's time for a huge main event that could very well determine who Kevin Owens will defend his Universal Championship against in the main event of Royal Rumble. We have four of the top five contenders to the Universal Championship. The number one contender, the Laughing Evangelist and Intercontinental Champion, Gerald. The number four contender, the Viper, Randy Orton. The number two contender, the Glorious Bobby Roode. And the number five contender, the Beast Incarnate, Brock Lesnar. The number three contender, Sheamus, lost in tag team action. Alright, so, huge matchup. Fatal 4-Way Hardcore main event of Raw that could very well determine who gets a Universal title opportunity. Let's get that match underway.
He rolls up his sleeves, and he just put on the ropes. He's got
the following fatal four-way contest is a no disqualifications match. Making his way to the ring from Grand Rapids, Michigan, weighing in at 230 pounds. The Intercontinental Champion, Gerald!
Here we go. This is the match a lot of these people came to see tonight. And with good reason, Michael. This one's been brewing for quite some time. Guys, this match will undoubtedly go a long way in determining just who is the most dominant superstar.
That's what makes this match so great. These superstars clearly have a point to prove here tonight and will likely do anything necessary to go ahead and prove that point.
Ready to get this match started would certainly be understating his eagerness right now.
Yeah, the opening bell can't come soon enough for him, Cole, and I must say, I absolutely love seeing so much enthusiasm from him.
Superstars who can legitimately win this thing.
And on top of that, this match will undoubtedly have a big impact on where these guys stand in the next WWE.com power rankings.
And there's been so much upward movement from new faces over the past few weeks that dropping more than 10 spots following a loss isn't necessarily out of the question.
And there's the bell. Before let's try this match set, again. My first attempt at doing this match was already an aiming match breaking glitch. Hopefully this one will be able to break through. And this is a huge match as I mentioned before. We're just 6 days away from Royal Rumble. This is the final Raw before Royal Rumble. And these four men make up four of the top five contenders to the Universal Championship, so the winner of this match could very well lock themselves into a Universal title match with Kevin Owens
in a fatal four-way match. You never know where the attack's going to come from, and it could quickly turn into a handicap match as well.
Take flight.
Oh wow, he's got all he can handle in there tonight.
Knee to the head and shoulder of Gerald, and Roode looking for a very quick victory, but Gerald powers out a one-on-one.
Just making his presence
reversal
felt
by
there.
Gerald.
Just look at this man. He's all business.
And Gerald is taking down Roode with ease.
He's inflicting
reverse
some serious
DDT
pain here. He lands
from
the
Gerald punch to the chest. Forces Roode back to his feet and a huge clubbing blow to the chest of Bobby
Roode. Strike. And that
there's
nailed him.
That'll plunging the body of Roode into the mat. Forces Roode back up. But Roode reversed and forces Gerald onto the apron.
Flips the script on him there.
And neck breaker from the middle rope. Courtesy of Bobby Roode.
For
Roode
some competitors,
Gerald
part of their strategy is to demean their opponent. A move like that says it all. Wow, Bobby Roode is
there's
being controlled now.
Gerald. And Gerald, getting pumped up, takes a bow.
Oh, wow.
Roode in the corner, a cannonball
right
from Gerald.
Yeah, no kidding.
Stunt
now it's Lesnar
shoulder
taking some punishment.
Again, plunging the body of Bobby Roode
might
into the mat.
Might too much for him to handle.
Roode up.
He's been gambling quite a bit here tonight. There's plenty. Oh,
and there's that
man
big boot. Could Gerald be on his way to a Universal Championship match? Goes for cover.
He wants no part of the outside.
And Roode powers
I
out of two as Lesnar and Orton
sure
make their way
what
into the ring.
Kick out. Not the
reverse
first
DDT
time
from
Gerald. Seen this move tonight. He's sending a message to the entire
forces
WWE
Roode back
locker
up
room
about reversal
here.
And that's going to send Gerald tumbling to the outside.
To the
Orton outside as well. Lesnar joining him. Roode on the outside now. Lucky not to go after Gerald, looking for a new
on
target is Bobby Roode.
One.
And he's going to go after the Viper, Randy Orton.
Randy Orton's in a world
there's
of hurt people.
Neck
this is an
Bobby
incredibly
Roode
bad spot for him to
Lesnar
be in here in this four-way match.
So the and he gets by it Lesnar with a as Gerald makes his way back to his feet and into the ring.
And
he's going to chaos
lands
on the outside. They'll go after the downed
down
Randy
the
Orton
spine. He wants no part of the
forces
outside.
Orton back to the ring.
Uh-oh,
joins him there
here
and looking for that spear with Lesnar
go
and Roode distracted on the
done
outside.
That
huge opportunity for Gerald. There's
the
spear.
Lesnar is working well right now.
Gerald goes for cover.
The
does
cover
he have
can
himself
he
a Universal title match
back
at Royal Rumble?
The ring.
Yes, he
there's
does. Gerald
and
making quick work of three very tough opponents. Gerald will take on the Universal Champion Kevin Owens for the Universal Championship at Royal Rumble in the main event.
In the big sleeves, he ain't just putting on the ritz. He's got thunder in his footsteps and lightning in his fists. You see, our God is an awesome God. He reigns from heaven above with wisdom, power, and love. Our God is an awesome.
Here is your winner, Gerald.
Huge victory here in this fatal four-way match.
That's a big win right there. Anytime you can pin another WWE competitor's shoulders to the mat for the three count, you should be proud.
That main event may have raised more questions than provide answers. We'll find out next time. See you soon, everybody.
All right, what a huge victory for Gerald, making quick work of three very talented opponents. Gerald just on fire recently. He cannot be stopped. Raw is throwing the best they have to offer at Gerald, and Gerald is plowing through them all. And with Gerald's impressive momentum he's been on, he could very well be looking at a Universal Championship coming his way following Royal Rumble. He defeats three of the other top five contenders, and it is pretty much a certainty we will see Gerald in the main event of Royal Rumble facing Kevin Owens, a man he has defeated in the past prior to Owens becoming Universal Champion for Kevin Owens' Universal Championship. Alright, and it's time for our rankings update. After just loading screen, of course. Let me get you your results. First of all, from Raw, Braun Strowman defeated NXT champion Ty Dillinger. Liv Morgan defeated Raw Women's Champion Ember Moon in a non-title victory. Finn Balor defeated Bray Wyatt. In an 8-man cruiserweight over-the-top rope battle royal, Drew Gulak defeated Kalisto, Noam Dar, Graham Metalik, Arya Davari, Jack Gallagher, Mustafa Ali, and Brian Kendrick. Kevin Owens won a promo battle with Big E. The Usos defeated The Bar in non-title action. And Gerald defeated Randy Orton, Bobby Roode, and Brock Lesnar in our episode 32 match. How does that affect the rankings on Raw and 205 Live? Let's find out, starting with the Raw women. Liv Morgan got a non-title victory over Ember Moon. So Morgan moves up two spots to number four. Ember Moon is still champion. In the top five contenders to Ember Moon's Raw Women's Championship. Number one, Mandy Rose. Number two, Nikki Bella. Number three, Bayley. Number four, Liv Morgan. And number five, Alicia Fox. And now the Raw Tag Team Championship rankings. The Usos got a non-title victory over The Bar. So the Usos move up two spots to number three. And the top five contenders to the Raw Tag Team Championships held by The Bar. Number one, Sanity. Number two, The Revival. Number three, The Usos. Number four, Authors of Pain. Number five, Bludgeon Brothers. And now the Cruiserweight rankings. Drew Gulak defeated Kalisto, Noam Dar, Graham Metalik, Arya Davari, Jack Gallagher, Mustafa Ali, and Brian Kendrick in what would definitely shake up the rankings quite a bit. So Gulak moves up to number two. Kalisto moves down to number 14. Noam Dar moves down to number 10. Graham Metalik moves down to number 6. Arya Davari moves down to number 9. Jack Gallagher remains at 15 because Kendrick lost as well. And Mustafa Ali moves down to number 5. And the top 5 contenders to Andrew's Cruiserweight Championship. Number 1, Akira Tozawa. Number 2, Drew Gulak. Number 3, Cedric Alexander. Number 4, Lince Dorado. And number 5, Mustafa Ali. And now the Intercontinental Championship rankings. If I can find the Intercontinental Championship. There we go. Braun Strowman defeated Ty Dillinger. Strowman moves up to number 16. Dillinger falls to number 14. Finn Balor defeated Bray Wyatt. Balor's not in these rankings, and neither is Wyatt. So that'll be in the Universal title rankings. Gerald defeated Randy Orton with no decision for Bobby Roode and Brock Lesnar. Gerald is still champion. Roode remains number one contender. And Orton and Lesnar are in these rankings. And the top five contenders to Gerald's Intercontinental Championship. Number one, Bobby Roode. Number two, Sheamus. Number three, Kofi Kingston. Number four, Xavier Woods. And number five, Big E. And now the Universal Championship rankings. Braun Strowman defeated Ty Dillinger, but neither of them are in these rankings. Finn Balor defeated Bray Wyatt. Finn moves up to number 6. Wyatt remains at the bottom, number 8. Gerald defeated Randy Orton with no decision for Bobby Roode and Brock Lesnar. Gerald remains number 1 contender. Orton falls to number 6. Roode remains at number 2. And Lesnar remains at number 4. In the top 5 contenders to Kevin Owens' Universal Championship, number 1, Gerald. Number 2, Bobby Roode. Number 3, Sheamus. Number 4, Brock Lesnar. And number 5, Finn Balor. And one more thing, too, that I need to update. Andrew pointed out to me that I did make a mistake in the previous rankings. I did update it here. In the previous match at NXT TakeOver San Antonio, where the Chosen Ones won via countout, however, did not win the NXT Tag Team Championships because the championship cannot change hands via disqualification or countout. That did still count as a non-title victory for the Chosen Ones. That would override TM61's victory over Undisputed Era. So the Chosen Ones do remain number one contenders. TM61 move up to number 2. Street Profits, Breezango, and Masa Sabatelli round out the top 5 contenders in NXT Tag Team Championships. So, just a small error on my part. I forgot the rule that a non-title victory equals 2 spots up in the rankings and would overrule TM61's victory. So, moving on to SmackDown Live. Are we going to see Dalton Roush in action? And still a week off for Dalton Roush. But he will be a participant in the Royal Rumble match. So I guess that's would be the silver lining for Dalton. Gets an extra time to prepare for Royal Rumble. Alright, so we will get you your results and rankings update for SmackDown Live. The Shield defeats Gable and Benjamin. Natalya defeats Ruby Riott. The Colognes defeat the Ascension. Samoa Joe defeats AJ Styles. Kane with a non-title victory over Seth Rollins. And John Cena defeated Sami Zayn. And how's that affect the rankings on SmackDown Live? Let's find out. Starting with the SmackDown Women. Natalya defeated Ruby Riott. Natalya moves up to number 2. Riott falls to number 7. And the top 5 contenders to Alexa Bliss's SmackDown Women's Championship. Number 1, Charlotte. Number 2, Natalya. Number 3, Tamina. Number 4, Billie Kay. Number 5, Becky Lynch. Now the SmackDown Tag Team Rankings. The Shield defeated Gable and Benjamin. The Shield are, of course, remain champions. Gable and Benjamin remain at the bottom, number 6. The Colognes defeated The Ascension. The Colognes move up to number 2 and swap spots for The Ascension, who falls to number 3. And the top 5 contenders to the Shield SmackDown Tag Team Championships. Number 1, the Hardy Boys. Number 2, the Colognes. Number 3, The Ascension. Number 4, Gallows and Anderson. And number 5, Heath Slater and Rhino. And now the United States Championship Rankings. Samoa Joe defeated AJ Styles. Joe moves up to number 4. Styles falls to number 3. Kane defeated Seth Rollins. Kane moves up to number 10. Rollins is not in these rankings. And John Cena defeated Sami Zayn. Cena becomes the number 1 contender. Zayn falls to number 8. And the top 5 contenders to the United States Championship held by Dean Ambrose. Number 1, John Cena. Number 2, Matt Hardy. Number 3, AJ Styles. Number 4, Samoa Joe. And number 5, Roman Reigns. And finally, the WWE Championship. Samoa Joe defeated AJ Styles. Joe is not in these rankings, but Styles is. He falls to number 3. Kane defeated Seth Rollins. But Kane is not in these rankings. John Cena defeated Sami Zayn. Cena moves up to number 5. Zayn is not in these rankings. And the top 5 contenders to the WWE Championship held by Seth Rollins. Number 1, Dean Ambrose. Number 2, Roman Reigns. Number 3, AJ Styles. Number 4, Jinder Mahal. Number 5, John Cena. And now we move on to 205 Live. What could be the final edition of 205 Live, depending on what transpires at the Royal Rumble pay-per-view. And we will see the continuation of the rivalry between the Brian Kendrick and Andrew in week number 1. Andrew became a fan favorite in the Cruiserweight division once again by attacking both Brian Kendrick and Hideo Itami simultaneously. In week number 2, Brian Kendrick tried to lure Andrew outside for a countout, and it failed. What will transpire in the 3rd week of this rivalry? We find out in episode number 33, but for now that it does do it for episode number 32. Be sure to like, comment, and subscribe if you enjoyed today's episode. Hit the notification bell so you're alerted when new WITM episodes are released. And check out WIT member Andrew's channel. It's called Andrew Spudstrong. And so episode number 33, this is Corey with WITM Call Wrestling, signing off.